While GeForce Now is not officially supported on Steam Deck, it is perfectly playable through the Chrome browser. Now, this does also work via the Edge browser, but there is even less support there. So let's deal with the Chrome browser and how to install this so you can play all of your Steam library that's supported on GeForce Now on Deck. First of all, you need to switch over to desktop mode, and then you want to open the Discover Store and search for Chrome. You can see I've already got it installed, but just click through here, and where you see the launch button will be an install button. Once that's installed, don't open it yet. Head over to the Start menu, System and Console, and you want to paste in this command. Now, I'll put this in the description and in the article as well for ease of access, but this allows the Steam Deck controller to work on Chrome. If you skip this step, then your controller will not work, and you will have to come back and do this with Chrome closed. Once that's done, go to your Steam library and hit Add a Game, and then add a non-Steam game. Browse down to Google Chrome and select this to add to your library. Hit Add Selected Programs, and then this will add a new shortcut. You can see I've already got a version installed, but I'm going to show you two different ways of running this, and you'll need a bunch of commands in here as well. So head to Properties for the shortcut that you just added, and you'll see that we've got all these launch options, and I will put these in the description and article as well for ease of copy and pasting. Essentially, if you don't add the next section, which is the kiosk mode, when you run this, it will run just like a regular browser, but you'll have your controller support and it will be a better aspect ratio for the Steam Deck. Now, the extra step, if you go to the end of this line and just before the two @s, add hyphen hyphen kiosk space https://play.geforcenow.com. And then I'm just going to rename the shortcut to GeForce Now for ease of telling the difference. Now, when you run this, it will run full screen, so you don't have to navigate to GeForce Now separately. And it will also be the perfect aspect ratio as well. So it will just launch like it's an app to the homepage. Obviously, you'll need a GeForce Now account and to log in. I'll cover a bit more of that in a little while. As far as the logos are concerned, you can sort them out in desktop mode by right-clicking the top section here to set custom background. And then in the library view, you can find the tile and right click these and say set custom artwork. But this is quite fiddly. And if you have Deki Loader installed, this is much simpler. And if you don't have Deki Loader installed, then check out our ultimate Deki guide at the end of this video and you'll see why. Because if you have Deki Loader and Steam Grid DB plugin installed, you can just go into the properties of the game and say change artwork. And now I can set those capsules and banners nice and easily with a whole host of GeForce Now assets here. Because I named it GeForce Now, there's already tons of assets available in Steam Grid DB, which are matched up. I'm just going to set those in and run GeForce Now. So now I have it full screen in game mode, just like any other app. Just a point to note that the home screen doesn't work with the controller for now on GeForce Now. So if you do set your controller layout for this app, you will need to use the touchpad or the mouse shortcuts with the Steam and trackpad to navigate around the home screen until the game is launched. But once you are in game, if you've got that controller layout set before you launch it, you will have no issues with games with controller support. So as you can see here, Destiny 2 running on GeForce Now, perfect with controller support. Just be sure to check out in advance whether those games have controller support and if there are any issues. We know there's an issue with Sons of the Forest right now, that the controller isn't working in game on the browser, even though it says that it should. If you don't have a GeForce Now subscription, you can sign up for free and try any of the games that are in your Steam library for up to 1 hour at a time with no charge. But there may be a queue for that, so be aware. And if you want to pay a bit extra to avoid those queues and get better quality, then you can get the priority tier at £9 a month, which will also enable ray tracing for supported games with up to 6 hour session times. And you can get a discount for 6 months by doing that at £45. Or you can have the ultimate tier, which will give you an RTX 3080 up to an RTX 4080 for supported data centers. And they're still rolling those out for £18 a month. And you can get a discount for £90 a month for 6 months in advance. That also increases the session length to 8 hours and gives you up to 4K 120fps support as well, which is overkill for the Steam Deck. But if you are going to play it elsewhere as well, then it's a phenomenal addition. and some of the other benefits that you get with the Ultimate tier are well worth it. Be sure to check out the Ultimate Decky Loader Guide if you haven't got some of those plugins already, and be sure to check out the performance updates that are available to get the most out of your games when you're running locally. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.